using a hybrid time series model. This will be the outline of my presentation. What is mean by crude oil? Crude oil is a natural unrefined petroleum product composed of hydrocarbon and other organic materials. It is one of the world's leading fuel with nearly one-third of the global energy consumption. Price of oil is very important level in the international market. Among them, price of crude oil is one of the important commodity. In this picture, you can see some of the products made from crude oil. Diesel, jet fuel, heavy fuel, liquid petroleum gases, gasoline. Crude oil prices exhibits wide fluctuations. The fluctuations are significant. There's a significant effect on sales and profit of major industries, influence capital budgeting plans, influence economic instability in countries. And in the recent research from the World Bank stated that for every 30% decline of oil prices, the global gross domestic product would be increased by 0.5%. As well as the drop of oil prices would reduce the cost of living and hence the inflation rate would fall. After studying all these research and research papers, we have identified that doing research about the crude oil prices is very important in the current economic world. So, our objective is to develop the time series model to forecast monthly petroleum crude oil prices with high accuracy. Crude oil price volatility will lead to uncertainty in the world's economy. Therefore, forecasting crude oil prices reliably and accurately is of great importance to the policymakers, economists, governments, as well as general public. This will be the methodology of our research. We have collected data from the World Bank data catalog. The data consists of monthly crude oil prices. We have used data during April 1999 to March 2017 for the model building part. And for the model testing, we have used data during April 2017 to April 2019. Then we have done the preliminary analysis. Initially, there were no any missing values. So then we have done a descriptive analysis. And we have checked for the stationary reading of the time series. After that, we have identified the models using the autocorrelation function and partial autocorrelation function plots. And the model fitting was done by considering the values of A-type information criteria, choose information criteria, and time-to-plane information criteria values. Then we have done the model adequacy part by considering autocorrelation, error normality, presence of heteroscedasticity. Finally, we have forecasted the model by using the fitted model. Let's move to the results and discussion part. Here you can see the initial time series plot for the crude oil prices from 1999 to 2019. You can see an upward trend in fluctuation pattern, and the data set seems to be noisy and non-stationary, and the plot exhibits volatility clustering. And we have tested the stationary by using the unit proof test, three unit proof test, and the test text is also in a giving the result that the time series of the crude oil prices is not stationary. So to make this time series stationary, we are considering the first different time series. So here in this graph, you can see there's a constant variance, and there's not having an upward or downward trend. And this data set, the time series is graph is seems to be stationary, but we have tested it using the unit group test, and the test statistics show that the first different time series of crude oil prices is stationary. After converting the time series to stationary series, now we are moving to the model identification part. Here we have drawn the autocorrelation function plot and the partial autocorrelation function plots. In the SEM plot, you can see the cutoff flags are at lag 1, 2, and 3. And in the PSEM plot, the cutoff flags are at lag 1. So after identifying the cutoff flags from the ACF and PSEM plots, now we are moving to the model selection part. Here we are considering autoregressive ARIMA models for the model selection part. So we are considering 15 ARIMA models and we are considering the AIC, SIC and HQC values. Among all the 15 models, ARIMA 110 model was selected as the best model when considering AIC, SIC, HQC having the minimum values of the AIC, SIC and HQC. So this will be the parameter estimate table for the ARIMA 110 model, and the model is significant at 0.05% level of significance, and this will be the equation for the best model. This equation indicates that the today's crude oil price is depends on the yesterday's price and the day before yesterday price. So next we are moving to the model adequacy part. First we are considering the serial correlation. So here in this screenshot you can see that the autocorrelations and partial autocorrelations are zero at all lags, and the Q-sets are insignificant. So it concludes that the serial correlation are not present in the data set. And then we are considering the normality test. So here according to the p-value it is 0.1091, which is greater than 0.05 level. So the errors are normally distributed. Finally, we are considering the heterosynastry test. The test value, the autorequisite traditional heterosynastic test stated that the p-value is 0.0330, which is less than 0.05. It indicates that the presence of arch effect. So now we are modeling for the volatility. So here we are for the volatility has been modeled by using both arch and generalized arch models. So we are in the table indicates the model that we have used for the modeling of volatility. So among all the arch and gauge models, the gauge 1-1 model was selected as the most appropriate model with minimum AIC value. So this will be the parameter estimation table for the ARIMA 110 and gauge 1-1 model. So then we have evaluated the performance of gauge 1-1 model by applying the arch test again. So the p-value indicates 0.7345, which is greater than 0.05 level, and it indicates there is no heterosynastry. So the final model for forecasting crude oil prices is given in the equation. So it comprises of ARIMA 110 and gauge 1-1 model. So now the actual versus fitted crude oil prices using the fitted model. So this graph, I think you can see the fitted models are likely same as the actual values of the prices until year 2017. Then we have forecasted the crude oil prices. Here we have used the data from April 2017 to April 2019, data for the forecasting part. The root mean square error was 4.3017 for the forecasted data. And this will be the forecasted graph. So here you can see the model adequately fits the data well. So according to our research, the model for forecasting monthly crude oil is ARIMA 110 and gauge 1-1 model with root mean squared error of 4.3017. Since the measures of the forecasted model are less than fitted model, this model is more accurate time series for forecasting monthly petroleum crude oil prices. And there are some limitations. According to the literature, supply and demand of crude oil, impact of natural disasters, gold price are some of the factors that are affecting for the fluctuations of the crude oil price. But our research is a univariate time series, univariate research. But after considering all these factors, we can improve this research to a multivariate by using multivariate analysis techniques like vector autoregressive model or machine learning techniques like artificial neural networks, etc. And these are some of the references that we have used for the research. And I must thank Department of Statistics and Computer Science, Faculty of Science, University of California for giving constant encouragement and support to do this research in a successful manner. And thank you.
So thank you very much, Ms. Samarakoon. So now the presentation is open for the discussion.
Actually, the arch test indicated that there is an arch effect in the data set. So we considered arch and large generalized arch models. So we didn't go for higher order arch models. Because the literature said that they are not very accurate, so we just tested for these arch and large models.
So then you compare AIC value to select the best
model.
You know that exchangers variable that has high influence on the response, right? So definitely you need to consider those exchangers variable in your model. So then by considering that, you might be able to get high values. So then rather than trying one model, in this case you can try arch model in exogenous variables. Very simple model type. And you, I think you might be able to get higher transition.
Please.